search for A/B testing, a lot of information. Google Website Optimizer is probably the most prevalent sort of, you know, kind of casual user tool, and it's all integrated with Google Analytics and stuff like that, so you can present different versions of your page. It's a little harder in Drupal because you can't sort of inject that stuff quite as easily as you could if you just had, like, say, static pages. You know, I can't, there's no easy way to sort of swap out with their system sort of what your end hardcore looks like for half of your traffic, and then, you know, it's a little harder to do, but, you know, I probably get shot down by a lot of, you know, usability people who are saying this, but really, you know, 4 minutes of A/B testing, switch your pages on different days. You know, put something up, you know, actually go in and manually change it on different days. And try to, you know, vary that in case you keep it the same days. Don't change it to something else just on the weekend, because that doesn't make a lot of sense. But, you know, you can try out different options. In a lot of these cases, you're really going to have to try something out and see what works for you. Where are people coming in through your site buying? You know, is there something that's different about the products that you aren't buying? And then trying some of these different variations, trying different, you know, add to cart buttons, trying different, you know, checkout workflows, different text on different pages and stuff like that. So A/B testing just means, you know, trying out actual different variations of a certain page and seeing which one responds better. So yeah, that's a little, you know, a little tip in terms of theming. It's really easy, even if theming is sort of like theming, I don't know, theming out on a CSS kind of thing. Firebug is just a handy little tool. It lets you, in your Firefox add-on, it lets you inspect the CSS and markup of your site live in the browser. So you can actually go and sort of click and see what the ID is of those options, and then just go in and, you know, make those a little bolder, a little brighter, put a different transition on them. It's one of those things that immediately guides the eye to where your customer is supposed to go next. A few other things that may or may not, you know, be important sort of for your use case. The Ajax card and Ajax attributes calculations. These are add-on modules for UberCard that allow you to you have an Ajax card so that you don't have to, it doesn't refresh the page when, you know, when somebody adds something to their card. And the attributes calculations is kind of the same way with changing attributes. So if you have attributes that are different prices, like when you have a large size that adds, you know, $5 to the price or whatever, when you actually click on that drop-down, in the page will refresh the price. Which is nice, and then it tells you, you know, if the drop-down changes to be, you know, now the medium is minus $5. So, depending on your use case, you know, that can be a handy module to have. Cart links is great. That kind of gets into the tip that I got here at the bottom. Another thing that we did was add a second add to cart call to action at the bottom of the pages. As you'll see in that couple of screenshots, I've got sort of a full before and after screenshot so you can see what we started with, what we did on product pages. But we've got a second link at the bottom. The cart links is sort of, I guess, the module. It comes with Uber card that lets you set up text links that perform some kind of action. So they add something to your card, for example, and you can use, you know, the product ID in that. So you can build a link and then put that in your template file or whatever that says, you know, when I click on this, it adds this product to the cart. So that's great if you want to have more than one add to cart on a page, or you want to put one somewhere else. Secondary links in the header, often great. You know, you may have the card block, and by default, you know, you can easily put the little bit more too, but, you know, adding much more information on the products, you know, I think, you know, I was reading a survey result, you know, that's still like one of the number one reasons people don't buy something on site, because there's not enough information about the product. Doesn't necessarily mean it all has to be right there on the product page. Maybe you have links elsewhere, maybe people need sort of FAQ type information, maybe they need, maybe there's specs that they're just not finding. I mean, this is one thing that we've, you know, we really learned from and from, you know, people, just potential customers, is, you know, you think that you're saying everything you possibly say about your product. Somebody will ask you a question, you'll think, oh, that's a stupid question, or what, you know, isn't that obvious or whatever, but obviously it's not obvious. Somebody is actually emailing you and asking that. You know, another thing that people kind of tend to leave on sometimes on sites, which isn't usually necessary, is like the offer date on your product content page. You can turn that off. In taxonomy terms, you know, there's a lot of reasons, you know, in terms of organizing content, maybe you want people to be able to browse with that, but just to be aware of that, because sometimes you get initially the defaults, you've got this sort of author date and extra fields, and there's these lists of, you know, what does it mean if it says, like, blue, which is at the bottom, and, you know, kind of, you know, those kinds of things, so think about that. So, you know, back to my point earlier about different types of information for different kinds of people, have that in your details, you know, more scannable and different kinds of information. So have things that are visual, things that are textual, things that are more like scannable lists. And, you know, some people, you know, maybe you have lists, but you don't have paragraph text. It's not necessarily just a one-way thing. I mean, ours used to be a paragraph text, and that was it. So we needed to add things that were more varied kind of information. But look at what you have already and add more, you know, different types. If you have no images, add images. Have lots of images in one line description, maybe need a little more description. If you have a list but no sort of descriptive, more evocative, you know, paragraph style text, try adding that. Because then they'll kind of hit on those different types of people. I mean, so that's our tip number three. Make your product details more easily scannable with multiple kinds of information. Okay, so making information more findable is also really important. As I said, most people are coming, you know, coming into your site, having to come through that sort of classic path, and well, I come to their home page, and then I carefully think about it and choose to go to this section.